Hello friends, welcome to SS Unitech. Sushil this side, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we gonna discuss about parallelism. So what is parallelism? So it is a great technique to improve the performance of our data integration operations, and it supports parallel execution of packages, tasks and transformations. So when we talk about parallel execution, then maximum concurrent executable property comes into the picture. And default value of this property is -1. That means maximum number of tasks can be executed at a single time. As Microsoft says, when we set n+2 value of this property, then we will get the best performance. And n is the number of process nodes. So how we can calculate the number of process nodes? So we need to go to on SSMS, then right click on this server name, go to on properties, then go to on processes, and here as we can see all, so we need to expand, then again expand. So here as we can see, we are having 4 nodes. So once we will set 4+2, it means 6, then we will get the best performance, and performance will also depend on the hardware specifications as well. So here in this case study, as we can see, we are having 2 execute SQL tasks. First, it will capture start time of this package, and in our last, and it will capture end time of this package. And inside this package, we need to use 10 execute SQL tasks where we will insert record in our table. So go to on SSDT to implement the package. So here I wish to add one more package. Then I wanna rename this package. I need to drag and drop execute SQL task. So it will capture start time of this package. So double click on this. Here we need to make our connection manager. So click on new connections. As I have already made the connection, so I gonna use that one. Click on OK. Then in SQL statement, I have already typed the query, so I gonna copy that one and paste it here. So this is our query. Let's have a look of this table. So this is our table. So as we can see, for ID 1 we are having 4 sequence, and start time is null and end time is null. So it will update start time and end time once our package will be completed successfully. So I gonna copy this update statement and paste in execute SQL task. Now click on OK. Again OK. Now I need to drag and drop one more execute SQL task, and it will capture end time of the package. So I need to use that connection, and so go to on SSMS, and I need to copy this update statement and paste in execute SQL task. Now I need to click on OK. Again OK. So we have captured our start time and end time. Now I gonna use a sequence container. Then I need to connect start with sequence container and sequence container with connect with end. And inside this sequence container, I gonna use execute SQL task. Double click on this and need to make the connection. Then here I want to write a query to insert record in a table. So I have already write the query. So this is our query by which we will insert 10,000 record in a table. So I gonna copy that one and go to on SSDT and paste it here and click on OK. Again OK. So we have done our first. Now I need to copy this and paste over here. And this is our second. Now we can copy and paste. Third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, So here we are having 10 execute SQL tasks that will be executed to insert record in our table. So I gonna connect these one by one. Then second, then third, then fourth, so here I have connected one by one. Now I gonna execute this package and to check our start time and end time. So once we click on start, then as we can see, our first execute SQL task will be completed, then move to second. Once second will be completed, move to third. Once third will be completed, move to fourth, then fifth, and it will take until our last execute SQL task will not be completed. So as we can see, package has been executed successfully. So I gonna stop this package and go to on SSMS, and here we can refresh this table and we can check. So start time and end time has been captured. So this package was started from 21:25:29 and it's completed 21:26:08. Now move to SSDT and design this package to run parallel execution. So I need to remove these connections. Now right click on this package and go to on properties. So here we have a property with maximum concurrent executable. So I gonna change with 5. So 5 execute SQL task will be executed at once. Once these 5 will be completed, then next 5 will be executed. So before run this package, I need to change our update statement, and this time I would like to run for ID2 because this is for parallel execution. Now click on end, and here I would like to change for ID2. Click on OK. OK. We can save and click on start. So as we can see, 5 execute SQL task is going to executed at once. So package executed successfully. Now I can stop this package and go to on SSMS, and here I can refresh this table. So we can check 21:28:54 is our start time, and 28:21:29 is our end time. So this package is executed very early. Previously, when we executed our package with sequence, then it was taking a lot of time. But once we design this package for the parallel execution, then it's going to execute early. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much.